Good morning, children. Today our topic is the Great Indian Desert. Okay, this is also called as the Thar Desert. So India has this one desert which is the biggest desert and it is very much famous and leaves a mark among all the countries of the world that this desert is being known. And where it is located, we will see the points over here. In Rajasthan, to the west of Aravalli Hills, the large rocky and sandy area called the Great Indian Desert, nothing but the Thar Desert, is present. So it is present in Rajasthan, it is clear. Okay, so in Rajasthan, to the west of Aravalli Hills, so we know the famous Aravalli Hills, no? To that Aravalli Hills, to the west side of the Aravalli Hills, this sandy area, which is having a mixing of some rocks also. Understand? So rocks and sandy area, which is spread very huge. I mean to say, for a long distance, this Thar Desert is actually spread. So here, we can find all the physical and geographical structure of it, where you have to learn here. And the extending of this, I will be explaining you the climate, how it is over there. Before that, we will see how it is located. It extends into southern part of Haryana, Punjab and northern Gujarat. So actually it is to the west of Aravalli Mountain. So clearly the western India is covered with this desert, that we can clearly understand, because this is to the west of the Aravalli Hills. Western India is completely covered with this portion of this Thar Desert. When we talk about the southern region, understand? So at the southern region also, it is extending itself to some areas or to some other states. So what are those states? You need to know it. So it extends into the southern part of Haryana, clear? Punjab and northern Gujarat. Now you can understand, in the southern region, these all places are being covered or spread by this Thar Desert over there. So the people who are present in these areas also, they can also see some part of this Thar Desert. Understand? Now you have to understand the physical structure, where it is present and till where it is extending to the north, east, west as well as southern region. Now we will see it very clearly. It is bounded by the Satluj River to the northeast. So to the northeast of India, it is bounded to the northeast of it. There is a Satluj River actually. Understand? To the desert, the northeast side, we have the Satluj River, and the Aravalli Mountain is there to the east of it. Aravalli Mountain is there to the east of it. So here, to the south, we have a salty marsh land of Ran of Kutch. So Ran of Kutch is an area or a place, understand, in the Rajasthan, where there is a salty marsh land also. That land which is there, it is a sand only, but it is little bit salty. So it has been formed many years back actually. Understand? The land has different forms. We have seen the mountains, the plateaus, the plains. Understand? So this is a feature of a desert actually. Desert is a loose land actually. Sometimes we can find in some movies or televisions, or if you visit the northern trip to India, once you visit the Rajasthan map, how it looks is, generally you can make yourself understand, like when some sand is there or bought under construction, you can find a building somewhere, you just go and pick the sand in your hand after it is being filtered, that simply falls and it escapes from your fingers. Can't catch it. And that Thar Desert sand is still more thinner than the sand what we see here. So that is how we have to describe this marshland of salty land which is present to the south. Means, for the south of this desert, we have this salty marsh land. To the east, we have the Aravalli Mountain. To the northeast, you have the Satluj River. And to the west, you have the Indus River. From all the four sides of this Thar Desert or the Great our Indian Desert, these are the places we have to know and understand them clearly. It extends to an area of 800 kilometers long and 400 kilometers wide. Now you can understand, for so much places it is extending, not over here and there as well as to all the sides. What is the length of it actually? So its length is 800 kilometers. Understand? And 400 kilometers wide. You can understand. How will be the length? For example, the extension of this will be the length and this will be the width. Understand? So length is almost 800 kilometers and width wide. How much area is extended? The width is 400 kilometers. Now we look into the climatic conditions. So we have different things to be known in here. The vegetation, yes, the population over there, the livelihood of the people, everything is given in this lesson. Just we'll see first the climatic conditions, how it is in summers and how it is in winters and other seasons also. So children, if we look at to the climatic conditions, apart from the various things what we'll be discussing in the coming class, like the vegetation, the population, the occupation, understand the livelihood of the people, we have to first understand what the climate of our great Indian desert is. It becomes very hot during summer. Yes, we know that always a desert is always in a very hot area and it will be very heat over there. And the places where the deserts are present, mostly they exist in as a hot climatic conditions only. So it is very hot during summer. Maybe when we compare it to other parts of our India, so the climatic conditions over this place is having very hot climatic conditions. Days are hot and nights are cold. So you can understand here the coldness is extending to 20 degrees Celsius in the evening. Means it is falling completely. How the days? The days are very hot. Maybe that will be seen here up to 49 degrees Celsius the days. And the night times it simply falls to half of it. More than half of it. Understand? So much heat due to the sun as well as the cooling effect is also in the same way. And it is in a reverse way, like it is very hot in the days, very cold in the nights. So that is the reason it becomes more dried up in summer. Why? Because when we compare the other seasons, the rainy season or the winter season, obviously the Thar desert has a very hot climate, and when it is considered in summer, it is very hot. And the land becomes dried up. Understand? Whatever the sun water or the moisture it has in its surroundings or underneath the ground, that will also it will dried up. Understand? So because of the temperatures, 49 degrees means almost it is nearer to 50 degrees. 50 degrees of temperatures during summer. So simply the sand or the ground area where we find little bit of water also or the moisture will be dried up. So that very huge temperatures we can find over here. And in winter, it may even reach the freezing point of -0 degrees Celsius. This is very strange. Understand? So you have to understand how the climatic conditions are here. When summers are there, it gets completely dried up. And in winter, there is a situation not falling on to 12 degrees or 30 degrees. It will get into the complete freezing point, minus degrees. Not even minus 10, minus 6, minus 4 or it can even go to minus 0. Understand? This is the heaviest and the more freezing point. This will be the more dried up summer. So completely controversy of climatic conditions are there here. So winter is very short here, only for 2 months, December and January. So basically we find that in a year we have all these months like we have the summer, we have the rainy and winter, all distributed as 4 months. Understand? 4 months for summer, 4 months for winter, and 4 months for rainy. But here, in this Rajasthan, the area of our desert, the winter will exist only for 2 months only. That happens only in December and January. The end of January, the summer starts. Understand? And even you can find here, it is not able, we are not able to mention the rainy season. Means you can understand very less rains fall over there. Almost there will be no rainy season. Maybe existing of the rainy season will be in a very less days. Understand? Most of the time you can find the summer season and winter will exist only for the months of December and January only. So these are the points where you have to remember regarding the climatic conditions of the Great Indian Desert.